So before we get started, how many of us are excited to be back in person at conferences? Yes, all right. All right, my name is Osama Shabir, and I'm the pre-sales director here at Turing. Turing was founded back in 2001, have been around the Cisco Contact Center world for a while. We develop most of the gadgets for Cisco Finesse, but we also do all the real-time reporting for Webex Contact Center, PCCE, UCC, and everything else. My name is Osama Shabir, and I've been working with Cisco Collaboration for over 15 years, and now I'm here at Turing working with the actual Cisco gadgets for Finesse and real-time reporting with dashboards and wallboards. We do have our demo layouts available on the website, and also our booth is right over there, and you can stop by and actually take a look at it, and we can talk more in detail about all the things we do. So how does Turing enhance your Webex Contact Center experience, or to say, how does it enhance your Cisco Contact Center experience, right? So what we do is we let the actual users make those decisions rather than just telling them, go to the analyzer, go to CUIC, and create your own views or reports. What we do is we let people create their own views. So everything we do is all about individual users. So if it's a contact center director, if it's an actual agent, or if it's a supervisor, each individual user can do their own things without having to call your IT help desk, right? Hey, I created this view two weeks ago. Now help me make changes to these views. So what we can do is we can actually let users do all of that. You know, your content, your style. So it doesn't have to be that, you know, user A and user B, they all have the same exact view. You can create anything you want. You can have different colors. You can have different pages, different font. You can bring in pictures and views. All we do is make sure that every single layout and view that you create is relevant to you as a user, regardless of what your job role is within the contact center. So that's the main thing that we do, is making sure that each individual user who is managing the contact center, whether it's an agent, whether it's a supervisor, their each and individual views actually allows them to manage the contact center. Real-time thresholds and alerts. So this is very powerful because, you know, right now, if you think about it, if you are using any of the reports, somebody has to be looking at the actual view 24/7, and, you know, hybrid work, right? Everybody is working all over the place right now. Who has time to be looking at a screen all the time to see if an actual agent went ready, not ready? How's your average wait time looking like? How many calls are in the queue? So what we can do with real-time thresholds and alerts is we actually work with all the major IM clients. So, you know, your email, your Webex, your Microsoft Teams, your Slack, your WhatsApp. We can actually create alerts and notifications based on the KPIs and then notify whoever has to be notified. So for example, this could be lunch break time for the supervisor. You can create an actual view or layout. You can say, hey, if average wait time goes over 15 minutes, maybe, you know, in booking.com space, right? Maybe 2 minutes is the actual limit. Then at that point, what Turing will do is send the actual alert into the Cisco Webex window or WhatsApp window and say, there is a problem in your contact center. So overall, what we are doing here is becoming your level one help desk for your contact center, because we are automating all of that within the actual Webex contact center, within the actual UCCX, PCCE, and everything else. We can also change, you know, as far as the alerts are concerned, we can do color changing, blinking, playing different sounds, right? Maybe you have a contact center floor, and then you can have like a buzzer sound playing if your calls in queue goes over 55,000 or whatever the number is, right? The number doesn't really matter. It's what you want in your contact center. We use the concept of business units, so not everybody in the company needs to be part of the same business unit. So we can actually create different departments as we are managing these contact center, right? So sales or customer service queue can have their own views, and then business side of things can have their own views. So it's very easy for us to create multiple departments, so you can nicely organize all these layouts and views. And remember, we don't charge by the layout, right? So we provide you to create these views, and then you can have as many views as you want. However, what you don't want to do is create multiple views, throw them in one screen, and confuse everybody, right? Because people in the customer service have zero clue or idea about the sales side of things. They don't want to look at how many calls are in the queue for a sales cycle, right? They care about, okay, well, customer service calls are important to them. So you can nicely organize different views. And then, you know, we have integration into the Azure AD, so you can nicely create user IDs and passwords. But also, we make it very easy to share these layouts with people who are not part of the contact center. So, like, for example, director of the customer service. They are not really part of the actual contact center user base, but they can still have access to the views, so they can actually see how their actual contact center is doing. We can bring in external sources into the actual views as well. So at this point, as you can see, we have the ability to bring in images, videos from YouTube, PowerPoint slides, PDF documents. So we can bring all of that into these views to make it a nice, you know, digital signage product, right? So we are not a digital signage product. Our friends at AppSpace do that very well. However, we work almost similar to digital signage, but we also work with a lot of digital signage vendors where we can bring in the contact center data through touring into any of the digital signage products as well. So we are pretty good at that. External users talked about it earlier, where we have the ability to provide these views to external users, users that are not part of the Finesse user base or contact center user base. So we can actually, you can actually share these views with them on a tablet, on an iPhone, on an Android phone, or just, you know, maybe there's a meeting discussing how your contact center is doing. So you can share the view as part of the meeting invite, right? So when everybody's talking about it, they can actually see how that actual contact center is doing. This is very powerful because we actually integrate with very popular CRM systems, you know, Salesforce, ServiceNow, and then any CRM system that has a SQL-based backend, we can bring that into these views as well. So like, say, for example, you have a service desk or contact center that is running on ServiceNow. We can bring, and we have some layouts available on the web as well, or you can stop by at the actual booth, but we can bring in ServiceNow data, create a nice view, and see how many tickets you guys have open, how many cases you have opened. We can bring all of that into these views as well. Again, another one of those powerful ones, especially since the pandemic and everybody, you know, going hybrid work, agents working from home. Back in the day, I remember deploying contact centers, you know, you just walk in a big room and that's your contact center. Now you have contact centers where your agents are all over the place. And the biggest problem with that is that agents don't know the stats. They don't know how many calls are in the queue. They don't know, you know, what other people are doing without messaging them. So what we have the ability to do is create these wall boards that can be displayed not only in a large screen, on a large screen display in a contact center floor. We can also have these views displayed on any web browsers, on your laptop, on your computer screen, and at that point you have the ability to send messages. So basically, as a supervisor, I have the ability to broadcast messages to these wall boards for notifications and things. I wouldn't say, you know, say lunch is in the break room because remote workers are not going to come to the break room, but there are other messages that you can send out for the team to see. We can also create, you know, kind of fun layouts, right? Who is the, some companies like it, some don't, but you can say, you know, who the top 10 agents are, who had the most calls and who had the least calls and things like that. But we have the ability to provide that. We also have a great partnership with the Stuffino, which basically provides your actual customer service feedback all built into contact centers from Cisco. So basically what it does is, how many of us, you know, when we call in and agent asks you, please stay on the call for a quick survey. How many of you hang up right after that? I do. Okay. So what Stuffino does is basically it captures all of that, not on the call, but when the caller hangs up, Stuffino will take all the information that we already have in the CRM system and send an email, text message, WhatsApp message to that customer so they can respond with a survey some other time. whoever does that, I mean, I get a survey and an email, I will get to it one day or the other, but live call, when you're trying to talk to a customer service agent, we are all busy, so nobody has 2 extra minutes to answer 2 extra questions. I don't have, and I don't think most people do. So we can do all of this as well. Power app or power tool, this was introduced literally during the pandemic, because as the agents and users were going remote, we introduced something called the power tool. This is a Windows-based application you can install on any of your Windows-based machines, VDI, remote desktop. And what it does, think of this as a virtual monitor, right? If you're sitting in a contact center floor, you have a large display or you have TV screens hanging, this is a virtual monitor for your actual computer. So you can create any of the layouts from Turing and you can display into this power app or power tool. What this does is, and does the same exact thing, so broadcast messages, blinking, color changing, all of that happens in the power app and power tool as well. But the beauty is that doesn't matter where you are, as long as you're on your computer, you will have access to these views in a window, right? You can have it always on top, right? You can put it any corner of your monitor or screen, and we have it in the demo environment. And then it allows you to show and put all that information to the actual agents and users. These are some of the sample views and layouts that we have. And then last but not least, talking about licensing and platforms, right? So the theme here is Webex Contact Center. So of course, we support Webex Contact Center with all the real-time reporting. But again, we have been with a Cisco partner for a while. So we do CCX, PCCE, UCCE. And so all of those products are supported. But also from licensing perspective, it can be cloud subscription. We can be self-hosted, where we can have self-hosted subscription, or we can have perpetual license, where it is your licenses and you keep. And then we do have live demos going on at our booth, where we can kind of show you every single thing I talked about right here. And then, let's see. These are some of the contact informations we have for our company. And at this point, I will open up to any questions.
Do we have any questions for Osama? We always take those offline, too. Sometimes people are a little squeamish to ask in a crowd.
Well, you can reach out anybody. Oh, we got a question. Yeah, so the question is, does the power tool do audio alerts as well? And yes, it does. And another cool thing it does, because it is a web-based, right? It is displaying our views are web-based. So something that I think I earlier touched on, that you can combine multiple views where you can, you know, maybe you need like more than one view to showcase what your contact center is doing. You can combine. So it will also do that. So you can have scrolling views in a power tool as well, along with the ticker that goes through. So all of that along with your audio alerts as well. You got a great question.